Hey everybody, my name's Adam, and welcome back to Let's Play Super Mario Galaxy 2. In the last part, we beat the game, and we're going back to 100% the rest of the game, and ultimately I decided that I would do a practice run and, like, try to find the green stars and, you know, copy this file and put it into file 2. There's no copy feature. Here, I'll show you. Would you like to start a new game file? No, of course not. And so, it's like, there's no copy feature, there's nothing, you just gotta start from the beginning. And I decided ultimately, over the 6 month hiatus that this was, nah, I'm not gonna spend 6 months playing this, like, game and, you know, we'll just go into it. Whatever, right? So, welcome back everyone. I'm glad you're all here. Hopefully, my mic does not peak at the most part. It has been a 6 month hiatus, so I don't know what my volume actually is anymore. Okay, we've already talked to Lubba, I gotta remember how to play the controls, I gotta remember how to play video games altogether. We'll get into why, for the most part, I haven't, Kevin, see me next time, the mail needs delivery. I'll tell you why I haven't, you know, been uploading, but where's the fun in that? I'll just leave you in the dark. No, we'll get into it as soon as we get into a level, as soon as we get back and used to Mario games. All right, we're back and used to Mario games. Where the hell am I? That's my main question. All right, so I guess we gotta do comments. All right, so we need to do the Bowser level comment over there. We're done with that world. This has a comment in it. All right, let's just get right into it. Come on, you can do it. Stop failing in front of everyone. Blah. All right, so the reason for a 6 month hiatus on basically all video games altogether. Adulthood. That pretty much sums it up. If you have never actually experienced what it means to be an adult, you might not understand that fully, but people have to work a full-time job, people have to work constantly to keep up with rent money. Oh yeah, I remember how stressful this stuff is. Did I get a Yoshi? Really? That's cool. Alright. Oh, well. Good start. Good start. GG, would do again. Alright, so. Whoop! Sorry. You know what? This actually does take a lot of concentration. So if I die and get a game over, don't blame me, because I'm actually talking and trying to keep a cognitive thought, which is really hard if you have never done ones before. Okay. All right, checkpoint. Can I? Oh, I can. Cool. Oh, that was lucky. In any case, so the reason, okay, so I would get a Yoshi there too. The reason for my latest disappearance is it all started with me asking for some vacation time at work, and it resulted in the ultimate vacation time that I possibly could get, which was going to the hospital. So the story about that is, I was working for a musical recently, and, oh man, this is gonna be difficult to talk about it. Not because it's, like, a difficult subject to talk about, it's just, I have to concentrate on the pattern. Like that! Like that. So, great way, I am amazing at video games, in case you haven't seen. I hate this. Welcome back. I'm not gonna take- Alright, I should have fucking done that at the very end. Take a little fucking break. Sorry for cursing. Alright, definitely not that for the first one. Oh, let's go find the monkey. Oh, I haven't even done- No, I have done that. I haven't got the comment medal out of it, though. Please don't be hard. Please don't be hard. Alright, so... continuing on. It all started with me asking for some vacation time. And so... I was working a musical show. And I was not feeling good at all. Like, whatsoever not feeling so good. And, I don't know what happened. I don't know how it happened. But, okay. I saw an extra ledge. It might have been back there. Nope, just a one-up. Okay, sorry. Oh, there it is. That was easy. God, I love being terrible. Where was I? So, I was feeling sick, and I thought it was, like, bronchitis, which I was thinking to myself, like, oh, I can survive through bronchitis, whatever. Like, I've had it before, it sucked, I was out of work for, like, 2 weeks, but, you know, it wasn't anything, too rash or too awful that I couldn't survive through. So, I decided to power through it, and I, went to the first show, or... Yeah, I went to the first show, and I was feeling awful. Like, if you saw me, I looked dead. I looked like I could just die on the spot, like, at any moment. And nobody really asked me to do anything at the show, so I was like, oh my god, thank you. Like, I'll feel better, like, probably tomorrow. And that didn't happen, so... So, where was I going with this? I'm sorry, like, I'm playing video games and talking about what's happened in my life are two things that I really don't mix. So, ooh, that was pretty. Shit, where am I going? So, that night I went out to dinner because it was like the first show done. And we were all proud of ourselves because we were like, oh, we got through the show. Oh, man, everything went great. And my chest was hurting, like, a lot. So that night I did not sleep at all. I tried taking a shower to get, like, steam through. But as soon as I got out of the shower, I vomited. And I was like, uh-oh, like, this is not good. And, so I laid on the couch, and my mom came out, and she looked at me, and she looked like, oh, man, you look like shit. And I was like, yeah, I feel like it, too. And so we went to the emergency room just because we thought it was bronchitis, and we were like, okay, we're going to get something. I won't go to the show that day to work on it, but, you know, I'll come back Sunday. And turns out I did not have bronchitis, and I had an irregular heartbeat. And not one that's like, oh yeah, my heartbeat's irregular, like, like I'm super original. Hang on, let me do this. You ready to take on the greatest game player in the galaxy? Also known as the chimp? I've got the high score of 10,000 on the game here. It's pretty simple, just stomp on enemies and then grab coins. If you can get my score or higher, I might give you a star and some respect, maybe. So, you wanna play the game or what? I'm gonna guess. You're going for 10,000 points! Good luck, you're gonna need it, pal. Fuck off, man. Oh, coins give you 100. Cool, I'll take the coins. In any case, so we went to the ER. They told me I had an irregular heartbeat, so I was admitted into the hospital. And as soon as I was, like, entered and given a gown and put into a room, well, they gave me a gown beforehand, but put it into a new gown, as soon as I got into the room, I was like, my chest really hurts. And they were like, okay, like, we'll give you something to ease the pain, like Advil or something. And it just continued on and on for 45 minutes. And they were all, like, looking concerned, like, uh-oh, like, what's going on? Little did I know that I was having a mini heart attack at the time. And, in case you don't know, it's, unbelievably painful. Like, you think you've experienced pain once in your life. Imagine dying. it's not that fun. My mom, being, you know, mom and concerned, was just waiting for me and my pain to go down, like, once it was done, and everyone, and she was, like, freaking out, like, why aren't the doctors doing anything? Like, what are they gonna do? And it's like, I don't know, like, I'm just as scared as you, mom. And so, after 45 minutes, the, pain finally went down, and, oops. I can do it! Yes! Yes! Fuck you! Here's the star, you earned it. So, we went through the course of the day, my brother and his wife showed up, and we're like, what the fuck happened, Adam? And, actually, no. He came in. He fucking came in and had the audacity to, like, with a nurse in there giving me, like, my meds. Was like, wow, you look like shit. Dick move, but funny as hell. They stayed for a while. They left. My girlfriend came and visited me because she was also working on the show at the time. Oh man, I don't wanna fucking do that. I'll find some other levels that I haven't finished. Sorry. I had to burp. Ooh, fire a nice level. I gotta do that still? Hang on, sorry. Searching for world first. What haven't I gotten? Oh, there is an extra star. Cool, okay. Oh, there's a secret star. I don't know where that is. And I don't wanna go searching for it while I'm telling the story. Yeah, whatever. This should be complicated, but easy enough. So, after Paige and my mom left to, Paige needed to go to the show, and my mom was dropping her off and then just going home because she spent, I don't know, the last 14, 15 hours with me.
Race, it's all on. I'm the best out there. You can play me. Of course I can. Showdown for real.
It's a showdown for real. I hate this, by the way. In case you don't know, I actually physically hate these levels. So she went home, and I was all like, oh, okay, like, good for you, going home. Oh, good for you, going home. I had no idea where I was going. I think I was supposed to just go straight, but that little bird went left. They went home, and as soon as they got home, I got up, and I walked. And I just walked around because I was, like, laying down for about 14 hours. And so, as soon as I, like, walked around, my left arm felt, like, totally dead. And I was thinking to myself, like, oh, like, I've been laying down too long. There, like, my arm has felt fallen asleep. Like, Jesus Christ. Like, I really need, like, to, freaking... like, stand up more in the hospital. And so, I hate this shit. Okay, come on. I don't think I'm gonna beat this bird. I think the bird won. Oh, no, it's still right there. Yeah, he won. Oh, by 1 second, okay. This isn't gonna be awful. I died of shame! So we hooey-hoo. After they left, left arm felt numb, and I was like, oh god. So I went to the bathroom, and as soon as I came back, I started feeling, like, the same chest pain that I had earlier that day, and I was like, uh-oh. And so, apparently, they had morphine on standby. And I was like, oh, cool, like, I've never had morphine before, but I've heard great things about it. And, so I told the nurse, like, hey, like, I'm feeling the same pain again that I felt this morning. Can we please, like, have the morphine? I promise I'm not a drug addict. And they were like, yeah, absolutely. So they shot me up with morphine, and, they asked if they could do an EKG, which is, in layman's terms, oh my god, I'm fucking pointing down, you piece of shit, which in layman's terms is, checking your heartbeat in, like, a professional level. Instead of, like, just monitoring your heartbeat, like, it's still going, it, recognizes patterns and, figures out exactly, like, what the irregularity is. So, again, like, fuck this piece of shit. So the nurse, like, knew I was sort of in pain, and she was like, okay, let's, can we do an EKG, just check it out? And, you know, me being the logical, rational person, I'm like, yeah, of course, like, do it in the midst of, like, the most pain. Like, it'll give you, like, an accurate result of what might be going on inside my body. And so they did it, and the pain was worse, like... I never thought I could have, like, a worse pain than that, but than whatever I had in the morning, like the mini heart attack. But I had it way worse that morning. And oh my god, if you don't fucking go down, okay, thank you. Just the pain was worse, and the morphine literally did nothing. Like, literal nothing. It's crazy, right? Like, you hear so much shit about morphine and how great it is and, like, how much it just relaxes you. I felt even worse with the morphine, like, inside my body. And I asked the nurse, like, oh, like, how long is it supposed to take? And she was like, 45 minutes. which, you know, I searched and it said 30 to 45 minutes, but the pain was basically at like a pain level of a 9 or a 10, which is unbearable. And Jesus. I don't know what they did. They took the EKG and the nurse just left, and I was in like heart attack mode the entire time, which later I found out it was a heart attack. One of my lower chambers basically just stopped. Like, just stopped pumping blood. And, like, blood was still going through because of the three other chambers, but, like, I was in the midst of being dead. So, I mean, that's a thing, right? Oh, no, that's a fucking secret star, too. I gotta come back to that. Should I just... Let's search for some more, like, easy stars before we go into secrets. I have two levels that I haven't even completed or opened. Okay, obviously that one. Throwback I've already done. I haven't gotten the comet medal on the throwback. Wait. I only have 600 and... Please don't be a secret star. Sorry, I'm figuring this out. And I'm petting my cat with my foot. I should be noted as the best, God damn it. I should be noted as the best damn multitasker in the entire world. I'm not doing the fucking comet medal. However, I will go to throwback and search for the comet medal. The prankster comet. Go Womp King. I'm pretty sure it's somewhere around here. I honestly don't... Oh, there it is. Easy enough. Jeez. Whoop. Ah. Gonna get the comet medal. So anyways, after the second heart attack, they called my mom, or my mom called me, actually. They didn't even, like, bother calling anyone. And I was like, well, you motherfuckers. So, alright, I'll just go the long way. Shit. I can't remember where I am in the story. Shut up, buddy. So, let's see. So my mom called me, I told her, and she was like, oh, like, I wish I was there. I was like, no, you've been here for 16 hours. It's gonna go away like it did last time. Just don't worry about it. And, so she came back the next morning, and she was feeling, like, really guilty about herself. Like, thinking, like, oh, I let my son... suffer through this, and I wasn't there. Motherfucker! Alright. What do you got for me? Better be a fucking cloud power-up, I swear to Christ. Oh, 3 1-ups. Oh, fucking perfect. Alright, time to go the long way again. Just to get the medal. Actually, can I... Okay, that's how you do that. I'm always lost in thought. So the next day, the cardiologist came in and it was like, Adam, your EKG that was there last night, like, I don't know what happened, but we're sending you to LA to get a procedure done. And so the procedure, normally how it is they send a small, like, a small, lengthy, stringy thing that's like a sonar device, which takes pictures of my heart. And so the sonar is connected to an outside camera, which they hover over me, and once again, take pictures of my heart and figure out what's going on, because they need to figure out if it's mild precarditis, which is what I have, which is inflammation around the heart. So there's a layer around the heart that becomes inflamed, and so basically it's choking my heart, and it's it's just stop, or every time my heart beats, it causes me pain, is essentially what it is. So, yippee for me, I got to deal with that for X amount of days. So, they had to rule out, like, the worst case scenario of my heart's dying and I need a new one. Which, spoiler, I don't. So they sent me to LA, and the procedure went flawless and perfect. However, they did something that was a little bit not normal, because usually they go through the groin because it's a bigger opening, and in case they need to do a procedure, which is the procedure calls for like a metal mesh in one of my arteries to be like expanded so that blood can go through. And sorry, life. Come on. All right, perfect.
Oh, that's my phone.
Sorry, that was my phone saying take pills. which I don't need to anymore. So, they put in like a metal mesh inside the artery so that it like stays open, so that it's not like constricted or anything. But they decided to go through the arm instead, because they ultimately thought, like, you know what, we're not gonna need to go through the groin because this kid's like 23 and this shit happens to 50 plus year olds. And, yeah, so they went through my arm, and they gave me something that wasn't, like, anesthesia, which is, just knocking you out. It was something that gave me amnesia afterwards, or short-term amnesia. So I went in there, fucking, like, it was crazy. Like, I love talking about this shit, because, like, it literally is, like, super crazy. Oh, I can go here. Why can't I? Oh, because I gotta do that stupid level. Alright. Let's just do a special level. Ooh, a special level! What do we gotta do? Oh shit, I actually have to beat the game, don't I? I got to beat the special levels, then go through the green stars, and then come back through all the way. Okay. I forgot about the green. Alright, I know how to play this game. Uh-oh. Stop, 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 please! Okay, there we go. Sorry, just making sure I got that one. Oh no. I love freaking myself out. Are you fucking serious, dude? Don't you even dare. Okay, come here. No, fuck you. And then you too. Oh, god damn it. Alright. Just gain life. Okay, now I can focus on the switches. Boop. What? Well, I had to do it anyways. Oh, I gotta make sure I keep... Okay, so... Sorry, the procedure went well, and I do have temporary amnesia. Essentially, what happened in the procedure was... that's even fucking simpler. I went in, they prepped me, and I was like, okay, what's gonna happen? And I felt a slight pinch in my arm, and I was like, ow. And they're like, oh, sorry about that, we're all done. And that's it. Like, they prepped me, and then it was done. In, literally a blink. Like, I can't express it any simpler than that, or any more elaborate than that, actually. Because it was that simple. So, what else did they do? So, procedure went well, they came back and they told me I had mild precarditis, which the, you know what the fucking treatment is? Just taking ibuprofen. That's it. That's all it is. So, I've been taking ibuprofen for the last month, and, I'm not allowed to do anything, or I wasn't allowed to do anything that, elevated my heartbeat over 140 beats per minute, which essentially is light jogging or walking from one end of my house to the other in like 10 minutes, which I can walk, or 10 minutes, 10 times, which I can walk from one side to the other in about 10 seconds. So, yeah, so I was on bed rest. I was doing essentially nothing for the life of me. And, oh my gosh, guys, I can't tell you how awesome it is to, just be on vacation for a month. Like, I mean, I had to worry about, paying bills. By the way, I have a Patreon. Go subscribe to Patreon if you like these channels. But, if you do subscribe to Patreon, like... $1, guys. $1 a month. That's really all I ask. If you guys do... Whoa, man! Hold up. Hold up. Come on. There we go. Okay, good. Alright, so... Thank God we got the common metal. I wasn't even thinking about that. But I've been on vacation for a month, and I've been really wanting to, like, let's play as much as you think, like, I don't, because, you know, it's been about a month since that happened, and I was like, oh, I'll do let's plays, whatever. I just have not had the energy, and along with that, I just haven't had, like, the free time to do it, because, like, as much as I was doing nothing, I was also, you know, spending time with family and friends. I was, talking to them from my own home, and, so, yeah, I was just busy for about a month, and Christmas, and all this stupid stuff. So, this is, after New Year's. To date this episode, it's January 4th, and I'm finally recording, and I'm actually planning playdates with Ramon, and we're gonna go back to Kingdom Hearts, and possibly something else that we don't know yet, because we're both lost, we don't know what to do. Excuse me. So, yeah. That is that. Ooh, nice. What's the next level called? Twin Star Galaxy. 90 stars? Ooh, nice. Or Twisty Trials Galaxy. My apologies, everyone. This is just a Sunshine level. So, with that being said and everything... Oops, sorry. That being said, and my story finally, after 30 minutes of me talking, finally done. Next time on Let's Play Super Mario Galaxy 2, we will get back into the game with high spirits and try to collect all of the stars. So, see you guys next time. Bye!